I got this feeling that haunts me. As real as the blood running through my veins. Now you're living right here inside me. And I'm just trying to cope with the things you say. Even if the curtain drops and the daydream stops, we might just give it one more shot, or just end it on the spot. Is this the final call? As we're stuck in a crowded ticket hall. Is this the final call? Tell me, what are we waiting for? 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 To nothing, I know I'm decided, but it's up to you. Different directions, different connections. I am going nowhere, but it's up to you. Is this the final call? As we're stuck in a crowded ticket hall. Is this the final call? Tell me, what are we waiting for? What are we waiting for?
I hear what you're saying, Voxbox, but as a counterpoint, if you work a 9-to-5 job, you don't get to choose who you work with. On a pro team... Wait, I don't think that applies to Switch Rivals at all, right? Because I'm saying from the coordinator's perspective, if you were to try to run another one of those, the first Switch Rivals where you're stuck with a team for the same week, or for the same month, practicing and scrimming, if I were the Riot coordinator, most streamers would not want to do it again if they didn't know their team in advance. And then a lot of people would not be happy with their teams. So what I mean to say is, like, if you're the coordinator, how are you going to convince these Twitch streamers to play? Because I guarantee you a lot of them won't if you won't tell them their team. Because a lot of people, like, had very unsatisfactory experiences from the first Twitch Rivals, not the second. Man, I just finished a recall. Hey, D-Blue.
My favorite part was when all the streamers got into one Discord room and started talking.
Oh yeah, that felt like high school.
To each other or throwing playful banter. That's high school.
I love that part too. Felt like we're all in a classroom. I'm gonna go for a risky dive here. Let her take mini aggro. Okay, never mind. I wanted mini aggro to do more damage. I think that's all I need. Delana's pushing towards me now. It's over, Kale. I have the high ground. Good luck. Okay, now it's level 6. And you're gonna have to flash away. Make sure I'm not getting ganked. Oh yeah, no, she's 6. So I have to start watching out for when she has max stacks. Oh man, okay, so I can't just freeze her there. Hey, Void Reaving. Don't let her get into ranged form. The only thing that can kill me here is a Warwick gank. I got a nice 22 CS lead. Where's Warwick? I have to play so safe just because I know Warwick could be nearby. It's annoying. But yeah, if I go in once and die, it's all over for me. Waiting for Warwick to show himself. It's been a while since he's appeared on the map. From the way that Kale's playing, I'm pretty sure Warwick is here. She's playing like really far up. She's almost like inviting me to engage. Like, try me. Try me. I'm ready. I bet Warwick's in that bush. Warwick is still not appearing on the map. There's no way he's waiting for me still, right? I'm trying to draw the Warwick out, but I have no idea where he is. Alright, I'm gonna guess he's gone now. I'm going in. Okay. Kale made a big mistake there. Well, first, Warwick showed himself, so I knew I could go in. But also, she didn't have enough mana. What?! Oh, man. I'm so happy with my little kill right there, and then enemy triple kill! Yeah, she also didn't have this mana for ult, so I knew I could go in 100%. Wait, her ult doesn't take mana? Wait, what? It doesn't? Hang on. Let me check. Kale. Her ult costs 100 mana. Okay, I was right. I was watching her mana bar closely. Oh, her old ultimate didn't. Oh, really? That's weird. I'm scared of the 4-0 Warwick. Sweet. $700 gold kill steal. Why did she do that? Hey, Slim Knocky. I feel oddly tired today. Every night I get like 8 or 9 hours of sleep, and I still feel so tired. I wake up exhausted. Something's going wrong. But I also, maybe I'm getting insomnia. I like, can't sleep. It takes me 2 hours to fall asleep every night now. I feel like last night, I felt really tired at 11 a.m. What? I can't English. Last night I felt very tired at 11 p.m. And I went to bed at midnight. And then I couldn't sleep. Why are you fighting me? Wait, oh my god. She didn't have her ult up. I was only trying to bait out her ult. She went in without it up? What? Can I catch him? Sorry about that corner cut.
Carol!
Corner cuts are the devil. They let you get away with so many things you shouldn't be able to get away with. Okay, what's annoying is even if I, or even with my 6-0 lead against Kale, and 40 CS, 50 CS, even with all this lead, if Kale makes it to level 16, she wins anyway. The pressure's still on. My animation pencil. Come on, man. Lost the kill. So, instead of rushing right into Cleaver, I'm gonna go QSS, because the one thing that can stop me is the Warwick ult. I'd rather be unstoppable and a little bit weaker than to be massively strong and stoppable. At least in a game where it's our game to throw. Kale, you thought you were safe? You thought you had a moment to farm? I didn't think so. Corner cut! I think that wave of CS was worth more than her. I'll get ditched. That Lucian came in to help him out. And Mikhail just flashed over the wall to leave. Poor guy. Okay, I should do Herald. I'm gonna clear this wave and get it, go get it. Oh, that cheeky recall. That's fine. Oh man, I got wrecked. I should have flashed. Oh no, I gave up a 1k bounty. Oh yeah. All right, that's a good idea. Yeah. Let's take the inhib. Let's go further. Oh my god, the Herald. Is Shelly gonna survive the whole way? No. He's gonna kill Shelly. Shelly! Shelly, no!